John McCain has a record of putting his country first as a POW, not budging in line in front of other POWs in terms of bucking his party, if that's what it takes to do what he thinks is right for the country on a whole variety of issues. But the question really remains, when has Barack Obama stood up and taken on his party on anything of national significance?
If flip-flop was an Olympic sport, John McCain be the first to win a gold medal.
I think Barack Obama's book, The Audacity of Hope, perhaps should be retitled The Audacity of Hypocrisy. Name me one instant, my friend, Rob, one instant where he has led on a major national issue and bucked his party. Can you give me one example? Not with 83 votes.
Barack has been a leader constantly on the issues, and he spoke
name
up.
One.
And I'll
name one where he's adverse to his caucus.
Look in his state senate record. I'll go back No, he has a career of this.
They shouldn't have had the meeting in Unity, New Hampshire. They should have had it in Politically Expediency, New Hampshire, if there is such a community. They had it in the wrong town. And I'll challenge you once again, name me one instance, in even one, where Barack Obama has stood up and said, I will take on my party on a matter of principle, on something large, as a United States senator, not some remote vote in the state legislature in Illinois.
You and I, everybody, we like each other. We've gone, our friendship goes way back. We've worked on issues together. In the last 7 years under George Bush, median household income.
Can you name me one?
I'm going to say median household income in Minnesota dropped 7,000. Uninsured went up 30%, and unemployment went from 3.3 to 5.6%. That's the legacy of the Bush economy, and you're struggling against it as a good governor, against a legacy of a mismanaged and a bad economic plan that has put too much resources over in Iraq and not enough resources here in America, and there's consequences to that policy.
Republicans have their own problem. Bob Barr, the former Republican congressman from Georgia, who is now the Libertarian Party nominee for president. What's wrong with John McCain?
What's wrong with John McCain is symptomatic of what's wrong with the Republican Party in these first years of the 21st century. They talk one thing but do something different, and that's become very obvious to the American people. And when you look, for example, at what the Republican Party in the Congress has done since losing their majorities in 2006, you see absolutely no new program, new leadership or vision put forward. And that's one of the reasons, Chris, why I think we see over 80% of the American people concluding that the country is on the wrong track and going in the wrong direction.
The missing man in this formation has been Bill Clinton. Lots of talk.
Hillary and Barack spoke the other day, and Senator Obama said he wanted to speak to President Clinton. She said, absolutely. What I think they wanted to do was, first of all, go through the event on Friday, the Unity event. It was up to Hillary. She was the candidate. As Bill Clinton will say, she is the political leader of their family. So I thought very important to the president that Hillary get out there first and do it Friday. He just got back from a five-nation trip around the world. Now that he's back, I believe in the next 24, 40 hours, they'll talk and off we will go. They will speak, and I bet you they speak in the next 24 hours, 48 at the most. He is raring to go. I spoke to him today. He's ready to go. He'll do whatever Senator Obama and his team want him to do. It's important for President Clinton that Barack Obama become president.
The surge was implemented by President Bush. It's now working. Senator Obama, unfortunately, like a lot of the Democratic leadership, continues to take a position that we ought to withdraw, which to me is retreat, accept defeat, even though the new policy is working. So I hope Barack Obama goes to Iraq, and frankly, I hope he changes his position, because if we had done what Senator Obama asked us to do for the last couple of years, today Iran and Al-Qaeda would be in control of Iraq. It would be a terrible defeat for us and our allies in the Middle East and throughout the world. We need a president who's ready to be commander-in-chief on day one. Senator McCain is. Incidentally, Senator Clinton said that over and over again, and she was right. She was ready to be president on day one. Why? Because our enemies will test the new president early. Remember that the truck bombing of the World Trade Center happened in the first year of the Clinton administration. 9/11 happened in the first year of the Bush administration. John McCain is ready to take the reins on January 20th, 2009. He doesn't need any training.
I think Joe has it exactly backwards here. I think being president is about having good judgment. It's about the ability to communicate.
You went so far as to say that you thought John McCain was, quote, and these are your words, untested and untried. And I must say, I had to read that twice, because you're talking about somebody who was a prisoner of war. He was a squadron commander, the largest squadron in the Navy. He's been on the Senate Armed Services Committee for lo these many years. How can you say that John McCain is untested and untried, General?
Because in the matters of national security policymaking, it's a matter of understanding risk It's a matter of gauging your opponents, and it's a matter of being held accountable. John McCain's never done any of that in his official positions. He hasn't held executive responsibility. That large squadron in the air, in the Navy that he commanded, it wasn't a wartime squadron. He hasn't been there and ordered the bombs to fall. He hasn't seen what it's like when diplomats come in and say, I don't know whether we're going to be able to get this point through or not. Do you want to take the risk? What about your reputation? How do we handle it publicly? He hasn't made those calls,
Bob. Well, General, maybe, could I just interrupt you?
Sure.
I have to say, Barack Obama has not had any of those experiences either, nor has he ridden in a fighter plane and gotten shot down. I mean,
well, I don't think riding in a fighter plane and getting shot down is a qualification to be president.
Really?